Hey yo, Chixo here. Today we're going to show you guys how you can actually 9k other guilds, or at least some strategies. And yeah, in general, we're just going to talk about the guild war offense, because it seems like guild war offense is a pretty important thing. Because yeah, we were fighting Corona Dragon, so of course right now we are in a lower bracket, so there's going to be less experience or a different meta going on. And yeah, so because of that, you have to basically make sure your offense is fine. And we're going to show you guys some teams, some alternative to your teams, and what you should basically do, or how it is possible to 9k a different guild. So first of all, we are going to talk about what do you actually do when you're going to fight guild wars. So in general, of course, the plan is going to be as usual. You are going to try to 9k if possible. So you're going to try to get as many points as you can. And the most important thing, do not attack those other towers. So as you can see, basically, here's one tower which all the lights land into, or the path is going into that tower, which means that one is the buffer. Here, for example, it's the no ult gauge buffer. And as long as they are not down, all other towers are, they are buffed with, I think, 5% stats, if I'm not wrong. So it's much, much smarter, obviously, to attack the buffers first, and then you're going to attack the others. In a usual guild, there are going to be 30 members each, which means you're going to try, the aim would be every person can actually take down one whole tower on its own, which is, of course, not the easiest. It's not easy at all, but it is possible, obviously. So here, for example, those are going to be currently my defenses, and you're going to go in with your setup. Basically, you're going to think, okay, you have four teams in offense. You're going to think, okay, I will attack this with that. Do I have a chance to beat the next team as well? If you do have a small chance, maybe it's worth it. If you don't have a chance, you just reconsider and think about something else which may work. And yeah, so basically that is how you can go through it. So let's say, hey, T1 glue, maybe not that great, but maybe T1 glue might burn through this, but there's going to be heavy green, for example. But if you can actually go through with T1 glue, I think you can beat this team, and then you maybe lose here, for example, and then you took down positively. So the goal is, as long you can actually take one defense down for one offense, that is fine. As long you get two or more, it's going to be a big W, and it's going to be positive, or more positive for your guild, and more likely to actually 9k. Coming to the offenses I will use in the next war on Monday. So on Monday we are going to stream. If you don't want to miss it, join our Discord channel, or make sure to subscribe, and then you eventually won't miss that stream. So the first team is going to be AM. So I think at this point of the game, most of the people do know AM is the strongest offense. Never use him in defense. So in defense, he's just way too wasted, and you can easily play around, like, just don't attack, and then you one-shot him with something. But yeah, coming to the next, Glue Eater. This is the Glue Eater I use. Of course, you can use other things as well. We're going to do that later as well. This is a classic suicide. So you're just going to suicide, both die, you have this ult to get a bonus turn, and then you ult with King, and then you're good to go. And this is a pierce counter. So in general, this is something we learned in Zenus as personal mistake. We did not bring enough pierce counter, and that made us lose the war. unfortunate, but it is what it is. You can learn from all those mistakes. Basically, definitely bring a team with Valenti, because she's going to be super helpful if you face Pierce. Because yeah, Pierce is a team, especially with level 90, it's gotten so strong now. And yeah, now we are coming to like alternatives as well, of course. This is going to be the first team we are going to talk about. So this is the T1 Glue Eater. I think this is one of the strongest offenses. The only problem is, in general, if you are going to attack in Guild Wars, people are not aware that you can't use links, so that makes Guild Wars a very, very difficult content to attack, even though you are just fighting against bots. But the AI are decently smart, Also, if you are going to use a unit in defense, you can't use them in offense. So that is the reason why we are in the team building, normal team building thing, so that I have access to all units, and I gave everyone a star who I might think it's important to talk about. If you guys have any unit, which I did not mention, but you think, oh, this should be used, let me know in the comment section so you can also help other people that way. So, obviously, this is the normal glue eater, right? And then you're going to decide, okay, which unit can I also take into this team? So, I would say another very cool choice, what we used back then, is the green Esther Rosa. Problem about green Esther Rosa is, unfortunately, yeah, he fell off meta with those, with all those red units, which are pretty strong. So glue eater these days, I would say it's not as strong anymore. I think the Chandler glue though, it's almost the same. The only problem is you can't protect yourself with immunity, but yeah, Chandler glue is also pretty strong. Instead of Chandler glue, I think I never tested this. I don't know if this is a good idea, but you have a dissolve, so it's not that bad, I think. Of course, not everyone has 6-6. So the normal glue eater is with LV as well, and yeah, I think that's basically it. So you can of course try. Oh yeah, there's one unit I wanted to mention. I think she's super fun. She is good. She also does have the dissolve as well. She can hit super hard. When her cards rank up, she buffs herself. So but her days are unfortunately over. I mean, maybe I should bring her back with level 90. I think she might be a bit stronger. But yeah, unfortunately, I don't have a cosmetics and stuff. But yeah, maybe someone who does have her cosmetics gonna be worth it eventually. Okay, so I probably should have mentioned where you can use Glue Eater as well. So I think Glue Eater can be used in almost everything. Besides of, let's say you're using a T1 Glue Eater, you don't really want to run into a Loli Merlin. Or if you're running a Glue Eater with Esther Rosa, you also don't really want to run into a Mono Red team. Of course, in general, the Mono Red team is strong because of the total focus onto one unit. But yeah, so coming to the AM team. So AM team, where can you use it? Almost everywhere as well. But definitely do not run AM team against a fresh new Archangel team or a Pierce team. So I learned it myself. So I know exactly, never do that again. So for example, back then, I didn't use my brain. I was like, guys, we don't have enough Pierce counter. Come on, let's use a fresh AM into Pierce. And it just got murdered. I mean, I won, but AM was the only unit which was left. But yeah, so this is basically the current team I will use. I think most of you guys know I used to run this, but the thing is, hey, he is SA1. I don't really like to use him, so I prefer Sigurtier. So this is one way to use. Also, you can use Chandler here instead. Works super fine as well. You can also use... So in general, I think most of you guys know Sigurd is one of the freaking best AM supporters. So this team is also very good. And I'm not sure if I forgot anything. But yeah, I think that's probably the most AM, most important AM counters. You can probably also use the green Esther Rosa here as well if you do have like super stacked Esther Rosa and his gear as well. So I think this team won't be bad as well. The only thing is, if you attack, you get attack related stat down. The good thing, the enemy too. So it's good, but also bad. The only thing is, so let's say Chandler, unfortunately, like this does not really synergize in my opinion, because yeah, her commandment isn't that great, but you could use Chandler with Sigurd as well. So yeah, let's move to the next team. Now we are coming to the Pierce counter. So this is the very, very classic Pierce counter. I think you guys might still know this from old videos. But yeah, with level 90, I personally am not a fan of this Pierce counter anymore, but it's still working. So it's still not that bad, but there are better versions now. So because of the, I would say, importance of suicide, you are not running him anymore here. So we are going to actually use, for example, Lost Vein. Either this Lost Vein or the blue Lost Vein are great options, I would say. and you are going to use the green small Diane. So green small Diane used to be in general very fitting to the LV team, but yeah, so wait a second, where is she? The green small Diane here. So she was always a part with the LV team. So let's say you want to run a different team, you can also use like red Gotha here or the red Merlin. But yeah, I think Pierce counter like this is one of the strongest Pierce counter. I would definitely not change anything besides of unless you want to change the blue Lost Vein. Or there is also one change, for example, you can also use the green Liz instead. So the green Liz is also great here because, yeah, if you're going second, you can just rush her ult and then you can ult and give everyone ult gauges, and that way you are able to get the ults pretty fast and you also have some sustain. So there's also, of course, another way, a third way of countering Pierce. It's going to be the Barn team instead. So we are going to put in this, and we are going to put in, there was also the Arthur here. So if you don't want to run Grimoire because like you don't have the gear, you don't have him built out, Twigo works as well, or any other red unit. But I really like Grimoire with the shield and stuff. He can prevent us from getting dissolved, so it is, in my opinion, pretty nice. I don't have that much experience as well, because yeah, also of course he with his stance, he does have the taunt as well, which can prevent from getting dissolved. So yeah, just see what you think is the best. If you do Twigo, you will deal more damage. So yeah, now we're coming to the last team. So now we are coming to the last team variants we are going to use. So back in the days, Suicide was not that important, but it became much stronger now with so many strong defenses that you prefer to actually do that 1-1 trait into a team, which is like impossible to beat. So Suicide is basically working everywhere as long you think about it. Okay, how do I play it out? Do I go to use double Suicide, or do I go to use one Suicide unit? So what does that mean? So basically, if you're going to use three units, you're going to get the ult in the first turn, guaranteed, if only one unit dies. So let's say, hey, you're going to fight against a team which has only a strong single target first turn, and that's it. If that unit dies, you are getting the ult. So let's say, depending on what you are fighting, let's say you're fighting a Sariel. Sariel would obviously attack him. So you just remove him from the team. You make sure that your Froden dies and you get the ult of King, and then you're good to go. If it's a green threat, you can also just remove her, and it's going to be the same thing, just that you have his ult first, and then you are going to be able to ult with this. So this is the current general Suicide most of the people do use. But let's say you are a bit newer, or you don't have them 6-6, or I think like 4-6 he's pretty strong already. His ult level, I would say, it doesn't matter as much, but it is good to use. So red Azarosa works the same. So don't think, I don't have the green Azarosa, but you have the red Azarosa higher ult level, use that one instead. Coming to the alternatives. So those two, unfortunately, there are no alternatives, right? But instead of King, for example, hey, instead of King, this is what the OG people used. The blue King, the green King, I mean. So the green King, he guarantees to crit. And if you actually pair him up with someone who can buff, for example, it's great. He deals even more damage. It's unfortunately not hitting as hard, so it really depends on what team you're fighting with. And this is not something you should rely on if you do have the Festival King, because Festival King is obviously much better. Instead of him, you can also use the here's the green. I think I didn't put on blue Easton, I forgot that. So blue Easton is also a great choice. Also, of course, the Emilia is also a great choice. So where's Emilia? I'm pretty sure here. So Emilia is a great choice, and then you can just play around, think about, okay, can I use it against this team or not? So first of all, like I said, it's basically a 1-1 trade which you are going to take. it's always going to be worth it, but don't attack into Fraudrons or into Athena. Because yeah, pretty obvious, if Athena kills a unit, you are getting dissolved and Fraudrons seals you. So unless you can survive actually a few turns against Fraudron, don't do it. But yeah, that's basically it with all the teams. Let me know in the comment section if I missed out any team, if I missed out any important important unit. Also, let me know if you guys know about any teams which I probably didn't even show. So let's say, hey, I really like to use the Red Gotha with Oslo, but that's not a team I want to show because it's not that obtainable. And also, it's not working that well. That's it, guys. That's it for the video. So here we have again the units I will use in my personal offense. You guys will see how they perform on Monday, or at least depending on which teams I'm gonna use. But yeah, I really hope it was helpful or you enjoyed watching this video. If you have any questions about Guild Wars and stuff, make sure to join our Discord. There are a lot of people who are super helpful. And of course, if you're new on this channel, I would be happy about a subscribe if this video was helpful or it brought you some joy. And yeah, that's basically it. That's it for today. Thank you so much for tuning in and peace out for now.